Hi guys, we will have a look today at one of my most modern avionics parts. It is a module from an obsolete radio navigation system, I believe. It is a Universal OSS module made by Universal Marconi Corporation in Canada. So this is a €1 eBay find, guys. Yes, as you can see, it is in pretty nice condition, and it is from the middle 90s. So my most modern aircraft part, if I remember correctly, is a 2008 or something like this. But this one is quite modern already. It is made in Canada. And you can see at the back here the connectors. It is designed to be inserted into some kind of rack with together with a bunch of similar modules. Here we have probably the power input, data inputs here, some dumb security things here, which will avoid you to insert the module in the wrong spot in the aircraft. And on the front we have one more plug for test purpose probably. So we will have a look inside now. So the way this thing is made, we have this front part which is also a pull handle, which can be removed, and we have four access panels on toward each side, giving access to the electronics inside. I will first remove for you this front part because it is quite easy. It is just a matter of removing two screws. But before it, we will have a look at the manufacturer sticker here. So here we have a warranty expiration tag. It is upside down, but I will put it right for you at least. So as you can see, it did expire of 1988. There is, it is from the tag from the Canadian Marconi Company Avionics in Montreal, Quebec. Here we have a manufacturer plate. It is so an Omega sensor system, CMA764, part number here, serial number 2318. Weights, mods, and manufactured by Canadian Marconi Company. So if I remove this part here, I will remove the connector, it will be easier. So it is a very, very nice quality plug, of course, with two set screws. Here we are, almost. Okay, here we are. So, Gagan contacts, set screws. We have here, so it is just the status indicator controller, it seems. We have here, this shielded module is a DC-DC converter, if I remember correctly. And at the bottom here, we have two batteries. It is lithium batteries, probably. Some jumpers. And at the other side, I believe, we have some surface mount stuff. So you can see the construction quality of this thing. Really, really nice. Die-cast aluminum or maybe even magnesium case. Here we have some wirings going to from one half to the other one. So if I remember correctly, I do not remember which way is the better to for taking it apart. So we'll try. It is just a matter of removing three screws for each of the covers. So really nicely made for quick maintenance. So here we are. So here we have what must be the brains of the unit. I believe we have some nice ICs at the other side here. But as you can see, it is pretty tedious to remove, to take apart, because there are all these screws. So yes, by the looks of it, it is mostly surface mount ICs, as you can see the footprints here. Some, by the way, you can see these connections here and do not seem to be very, very secure for something mounted into an aircraft. There is no really anything clamping them down. So you can see the other cover here is just blank. There is nothing mounted on it. Quite interesting. So maybe I will remove this panel for you later. So we have a look at the other side. So the other side, if I remember correctly, we'll try this one. So as the thing looks in really nice condition, I do not want to damage anything. So you will notice that the screws at the bottom here are metal colored, while the one on the top are black, for purely aesthetics. So here we have big rubber thing here, and a huge PCB. It is written Omega VLF receiver with, you can see, flat flex interconnects. This is really nice. We have here big capacitor, big coil for a power supply. And I have to open it the other side in order to see the parts. Here. So I did access the wrong side. More screws, but this thing is quite easy to work on. So here we are. Panel, and we have the other side of the thing. As you can see, it is pretty cute. I will zoom in for you. We are, I believe, is it in focus? Yes. So we have here some module made by McCoy. It must be a frequency oscillator. Yes. Free 900 MHz, it is written. So, regular leader connectors here. Bottom PCB here with big weird orange caps, as you can see here, with golden connections. Small Aris chips. Decor 1983, It is written 11-5042-5. Small logic chips here. You can see here bypass caps, it seems, for the power supply or something like this. Here we have more. We have a LT1011 chip here. More Aris stuff. And all the numbers on these chips I do not recognize. They are custom things, it seems. So it looks like it may pull out, but I will not do it because of the wiring here. So we have a big, maybe a controller chip here. Yes, it is a MC68701, so it is a microcontroller, 60A series, probably. And here we have these cans, which are written band pass filters, with input-output, and each time we have different frequencies written on it, as you can see. Not sure if it can be removed or not. Maybe. Yes. Not sure. No. There are these screws at the back here. Probably for keeping them attached, but I believe there are solders. So it is there are solder in place, so I will not be able to remove them. Okay, so I will put back this in place and we will have a look to the main brain's PCB. It's quite a pain, but the PCB is loose now. So first, we can see here you have some unpopulated connector. So maybe it is either for firmware upgrade, memory expansion, test purpose, something like this. Here we have a little add-on PCB with one chip, which is MM58274CN. You can Google it if you want. Then if I lift this PCB, some bulge here, you can see. And here we are. We have two big chips. You can see the quality of this PCB, by the way. Conformal coating and all the fancies. Big resistor networks here, it's made by Dale. So the main chips, we have an Intel thing here. You have numbers for you. LT314928. That code 1980, so it is an old one with a ceramic case. And one other thing here, it must be an EEPROM. 27C210Q with a sticker, so we must have an erasing window behind it. Some LSI clips. So if you can, yes, you can get the numbers. The very, very long model numbers on the clips. National Semiconductor here, I believe. SCX6225PFU. Some smaller ones here. One which is co-signed by Aris and Intel here. CS86ATCX6. That code 1978 here. So by the way, for a 90s device, they use very, very old chip designs. So the package is more modern than 1978, but the chip inside must be this old. And here we have what looks like RAM, chips with provision for adding more of them, which are not populated here. And you can see here again this nice capacitors in with golden legs. Some little weird thing here with a little window, must be a quartz maybe. There are two other quartz here and here. Okay. So not sure how many layers we have on this PCB. It has an individual serial number, by the way. It is quite thick already. The and the connector here is made by Airborne. Okay, so I will put it back together. Thanks for watching. Bye bye.